Hi, everybody. It's Jessica DeMassa with What's the Future Health? I am lucky enough to be talking to the who's who of health tech and healthcare innovation. And today, huge congratulations to this guy, the co-founder, CEO, and chairman of Sharecare, which is about to start trading on the NASDAQ under the ticker symbol SHCR tomorrow, Jeff Arnold. Thank you so much for dropping by.
Thanks, Jessica. It's nice to be here. Thanks for having me.
Okay, so where are we at right now? We are in this moment where the vote has been approved, the transaction is closed, you're starting to trade tomorrow. I mean, tell us what's going on. How's everybody feeling about this? You've got like your celebrity co-founder, Dr. Oz, out there. You've got a list of partners that includes Sony, Harpo, Discovery. How's everybody feeling about the deal?
I think everybody's happy. We kind of started this journey late last year, and we announced it in February, and we've learned tons about SPACs. I'm sure you have too.
And
we're here, kind of on the final countdown, and just real excited that we got through it and that we're in great shape. And we feel like our readiness to be a public company is really strong, and I'm super happy for all our shareholders, including Dr. Oz and all our early supporters.
All right, I want to dive into how market ready you are. You are walking into the market with zero debt, $400 million in cash to invest. So let's talk about that for a second right there before we start dishing about SPACs, because I do have some questions about that.
Okay,
all right, so tell me about this $400 million and paint us a picture about what's about to happen over the next 18 months. You guys have a history of being a very acquisitive business. And for those who are not really familiar with the history of Sharecare, check out my other interview with Jeff. We talked about 2 months ago, dove deep into the business model, but I wanna hear about some of these business lines that you're building out with that 400 million.
Okay, so let me tell you the best part about the 400 million is that we also do 400 million in revenue. And so, we're a $400 million revenue company that's EBITDA positive. So this new growth capital of $400 million isn't going to fund losses, it's going to fund growth. And so we're going to be investing in M&A. We're going to be investing in product development. We're hiring over 90 salespeople in enterprise alone. Wow. So it's going to grow. And so we're looking forward to the expansion opportunity.
All right, let's talk about some of those product lines here so that folks are kind of caught up to speed on exactly like what it is that you were scaling out. So I kind of refer to you guys as like you're like a population health company / care navigator / health security company. That was a new line that was launched at the end of COVID to verify businesses as being safe. So, I mean, what parts of these, of the business model, which of these verticals are you focusing on?
Okay, so think of us as a health management platform.
Okay.
So, so we have 450 people that work in product and tech. So real robust tech team. And that one platform we sell to enterprise. And so that would be like government clients or self-insured employers like a Delta or big health plans like Blue Cross Blue Shield plans. And we generate about $239 million in revenue this year selling to those groups. We then take that same platform and we bring that to health systems. And so we have over 6,000 clients, and that division does about $100 million for us right now. And then lastly, we take that one platform direct to consumer, and that's about a $65 million operating unit for us now, but allows us to invest heavily in content, for example, that I think we've got the best content library anywhere that allows us to create what I call data-driven dialogue. So as I take data in from you, how do I explain it back to you in a way that gets you to make the healthy choice the easy choice? So one platform for health management that we leverage across enterprise, provider, and consumer with the spirit of all together better. So take all the things that you just said, population health to health security to disease management, we do it all together better.
All right. I have to ask this because I feel like, this is so typical of like healthcare. We try to put people in their boxes. We try to make sure that we just label you appropriately so we can move on. I hear you guys are often compared to Accolade. And to me, you don't sound anything like Accolade. Who do you think you compete with? Or are you guys so singularly unique with this business model? There is no competition but the status quo. Please don't say that to me.
Well, we call it a category of one. So we believe we're a category of one, and we believe that because we think we have a very comprehensive platform. We're really well diversified. So we have lots of different clients across lots of different segments. We like to believe that we get hired for our innovation. And because we're operators. And so like when I look at our leadership team, I often say like, you know, we have innovators, we have operators, we're profitable, but we're also unifiers. And you talked about some of our investors as an example, but we're constantly trying to bring everybody together. If you think of us like a cake, like a wedding cake, on the bottom, you would have enterprise, right? Which is our $239 million. And we compete it with Accolade in our enterprise business as one of our competitors. But at the same time, we believe that the doctor can't be left out of this equation, and that for digital health to fulfill its promise, that the technology should build a stronger bond between patient and provider, not weaken it. And so we have a big effort, $100 million division there. And then lastly, on the consumer side, we think we're building the Sharecare brand to be put in a very envious place that allows us to have brand permission with you as a person that's different from any of the competitors that we might be compared to. And so it's just neat, like you mentioned health security. So we announced this week that the first cruise ship that left the US, the Celebrity Cruise Line, Sharecare verified the ship before it left port and at every stop along the way, so that the passengers and crew and everybody knows that, you know, kind of safety first, you know, they're ready to sail. And so just a unique way to use technology in a very important way to build the Sharecare brand and build trust with users.
I love this. And I feel like there's been so much attention like about the digital front door. And it's like everybody is fighting for control over that digital front door. And your layer cake of a business model, to me, it's like all of those layers are really involved in terms of there are companies that at each of those stages, I should say, that are really fighting for control over that digital front door. Who wins this? How do we win? If you're aiming for that digital front door, I mean, where you guys are like the thing that people go to as their trusted health resource, you know, have a relationship, willing to share their health data, willing to go and navigate from Sharecare to other points in the healthcare system. How do you win that digital front door?
Yeah, it's such a great point. And I think why everybody's trying to do that is that we recognize that, you know, you don't have 10 apps to manage your money. So why would you have 10 apps to manage your health, right? So there needs to be, you know, a one-stop shop. The way we've gone about it is we think to win that digital front door, there needs to be three pillars. The first pillar is all around the social determinants of health. So, you know, how does where you live, work, and play affect your health as much as your genetics and lifestyle? So we've made a huge investment in our community well-being index, where we rank well-being at every zip code in the US. And then we use that to benchmark the effectiveness of Sharecare. But you need to understand your environment and the impact on your health. Second is this new emerging layer, which we call health security, which we think is going to be like cybersecurity going forward. Cybersecurity protects infrastructure against a virus. Health security, best practices, tech enabled, will help protect people against future threats. And so that's a pillar that I think is going to be important. And then lastly is our core business pillar, which is all about building resilience. And so how do I build a platform that helps you understand your baseline? For us, that's your real age. Helps you understand your real time, so that's your daily activities. We call that a green day. And then ultimately takes you on a data-driven journey. So what is your journey versus my journey that helps you know your numbers, reduce your risk, manage your conditions, navigate your benefits, know how to access the healthcare system, and understand the role of money. And with Sharecare, you know, we're working really hard to really make those three pillars work together so that as I build resilience, I'm strengthening health security and I'm improving well-being.
And say for us, a little bit more about what you just said about understanding the role of money in this. What do you mean by that?
Well, I think as we go into, you know, next year, as we go over 50% and self-insured employers and high deductible plans and bundled payments and ACOs and, you know, follow all the different trails of money in healthcare, whether you're at CMS or you're with the commercials or with employers, it's really confusing to people. Right? So do I use an HSA dollar or an FSA dollar, or do I use my incentive dollars this way or that way? And can I be rewarded for healthy behavior, which is what we're hoping to do? And so I think just understanding your options and how to choose the best plan and how to choose the right incentive structure for you, so you maximize your healthcare dollar as you become a more informed healthcare consumer, like in all other roles of your life, you're gonna wanna have more transparency and the best recommendations.
Yeah, there's a lot changing in this whole benefits design world, and also just the way that people are consuming their healthcare. I mean, you've already talked a little bit about this health security vertical that you guys have established. I'd love to hear a little bit more about that as well, just because I feel like you guys are sitting almost on the top of like two converging trends as far as I've seen it as a result of COVID. It's like, I feel like the way that people have been looking at healthcare has changed, specifically on the, you know, the cost aspect of things, with that rise of the large self-insured employer being a little bit more activist than we've previously seen, and with health plans and health systems kind of suffering through the pandemic, you know, and having to deal with financial situations created by that anomaly. And then the other side of it, it's like, here we have this, you know, real concern about making sure that everybody is safe and protected. Talk a little bit about how you guys are trying to jump ahead of this curve with some of these new products and services that you're launching.
Well, I think at the tipping point is we want to have broad brand permission to be your digital health partner. And so, you know, I might one day be asking a user to join a diabetes prevention program because I know they're at risk of becoming diabetic. Or another day, I might be helping people, you know, choose what the right health plan is for them, or encouraging a user to share their data with their doctor, or helping a state use our technology to put the vaccine in people's arms. We want that broad brand permission with you, and we want you to trust us. We want you to know that we protect your data and that we're gonna give you the right, best action always. That's where we start. And where health security just came into this is, one is I saw it a great way to brand Sharecare, is that I was looking around, I said, the world's gonna reopen. Right? People, you know, how are you going to get employees back to, you know, hotels and cruise ships and arenas and schools and offices? And so looking around, I'm like, this is so fragmented. Everybody's doing their own thing. So imagine if you're a travel agent and you're calling every hotel because your client wants to know what the protocols are. So we said, let's build a conversational AI chatbot that takes the best practices for being COVID ready and tech enable it, and then verify people on a monthly basis. And it might be the most viral thing I've ever been involved in that we've created. It's been adopted in 75 countries already.
Wow.
And I saw one of my marketing folks was telling me last week or so that we've generated over 3 billion media impressions of people bragging about their Sharecare verification. And so you'll see it, like the CEO of Celebrity Cruises talking about what it means to be Sharecare verified, to give confidence to their employees and their guests. And it's a great revenue opportunity. And it's a great way to expose Sharecare to all these places that we haven't before. I mean, if you just take hospitality as an example, they're the largest employer of any vertical. And so, and you know, we didn't have a lot of business in that space. And now we're doing business with all these different hotel chains and cruise lines and live venues. And so it's been great.
I hate to tell you this, but I think people are going to start talking about Sharecare for a different reason here starting tomorrow. So yeah. Let's talk a little bit about the launch of the ticker symbol. Let's talk a little bit about you guys with the SPAC IPO. Like, I have got to ask you a question, if I may, about these SPAC IPOs, because, and granted, my sample size is pretty small here because there haven't been too many health tech companies that have gone through this. But I feel like by the time they come to me, you guys look a little bit tired. So is this different than like a typical IPO? I mean, I usually feel like the typical IPO, and again, sample size small, everybody is jazzed at the end. These SPACs, it's like the paperwork or whatever it is to get that deal done. Everybody comes to me looking a little bit tired. So what's been your experience?
Well, regardless of how I look, I don't feel tired.
You don't look tired. I didn't mean it like that, Jeff. I didn't mean it like that.
And I could see how you could experience SPAC fatigue, you know, because it's a process. And I think the reason it's a process is the way a SPAC works, as you know, is it starts with a blank check corporation that goes out and creates a trust, and they don't know what they're investing in yet. And then the way you validate that price is then once there's a target like Sharecare, you go out and you do a pipe. And the pipe kind of is to give confidence to the trust investors that this is the right valuation and this is a great company, et cetera. But they're different shareholder bases, right? So, you know, so where you get, I could see you could get some SPAC fatigue is you're educating a blank check investor on now what is Sharecare, you know, and then as you know, as we've had a couple conversations, is we've got a lot going on and healthcare is really complicated. And so to be able to get that investor, sometimes even retail investors, to understand healthcare and what Sharecare is and why we're a category of one is an education process. And then while you're doing that, you've got your pipe investors, which is more like a traditional IPO type investor, at least it was for us. Right. And it was really fun because we went out for a $250 million pipe and we got way oversubscribed and ended up doing a $425 million pipe. But what was great about it is it wasn't a 20-minute roadshow. You could spend an hour with an investor. You could give forecasts, which you can't otherwise, and you could do follow-up meetings. And so I feel like it's a lot since February, but being able to have that much time to tell our stories to investors that we want to be in Sharecare for the next, 10, 20 years has been worth it. But I could see, I hear your point, and we're glad, believe me, we're glad we're coming out on the other end and we're in the countdown here.
And geez, I did not mean it that you look tired. I just feel like everybody gets here a little bit like, okay. It's like up to the wire. Like, is it going? Is it not going? Like, it's just, it seems like there's a little bit more drama. So I have to ask you this then. You mentioned your investor deck and your roadshow, and I think you've hit a lot of the highlights here. Any other thing that you want to kind of put a little spotlight on before we go, as far as what people need to be aware of in terms of investing in Sharecare?
Well, I think two things have happened since we talked last is, one, I think we were just closing the Doc.AI acquisition. So we picked up amazing AI, I call them futurists, up in Palo Alto that are helping inform our product roadmap and has been like hand in glove because AI needs data and data needs insights. And so they fit together really nicely. Mm-hmm. And we got introduced to Doc.AI via Anthem because Anthem was an investor and had just done like a $100 million AI contract with Doc.AI. So when we acquired Doc.AI, we deepened our relationship with Anthem. And since I spoke to you last, Anthem made a $50 million direct investment into Sharecare in April and has joined our board of directors. And as you know, Anthem's the second largest health insurance company in the US. And so we're excited about having the opportunity to hopefully be able to grow our services with them and have them, help us build really great products.
That's awesome. And then I wanted to ask you, just for you personally, Jeff, like this is the third business that you've built that you've taken to an exit. WebMD, How Stuff Works, sold to Discovery. I mean, you're on a roll here, my friend. This one valued at just about $4 billion on this IPO. I mean, what's next, my friend?
Actually, my fourth.
Fourth? I missed one.
And fifth, if you count the one startup where I was chairman. But
All right, show off. Just tell us how you feel about this one, okay?
Who's counting? No, I'm just teasing. Now, this one feels really great, and I'll tell you why really fast. Is I was much younger when I did WebMD, and so I was like in my 20s. It was way back in 1998, and everything felt really easy, and I don't think I appreciated as much as I should have at the time of how special it was. And when I left healthcare, we did some other things where we could make money and sell businesses and things like that, but I missed the impact that healthcare has, right? The true way that you can make a difference in somebody's life. And so to be able to have a second bite at the apple, but being a little bit older and hopefully a little bit wiser, but yet still with a lot of my same core team, feels like a giant privilege. And we're honored to be able to have this opportunity to build Sharecare for our clients and our users, and thankful for folks like yourself who give us a platform to be able to talk about it.
We're your biggest cheerleaders. We just want to see everybody do well. So that we can fix healthcare. That's it. That's what it comes down to, right?
I do think it is an altogether better. I mean, all boats rise with the tide here. I think all of us have an obligation to get this right. And COVID, put a spotlight on that, how important this topic is. And I think the Operation Warp Speed and the vaccine gives us real hope. I mean, things can happen fast.
Yeah, who knew?
Yeah, so.
I mean, truly, you've been in healthcare for a long time. Who knew things could happen this quickly? Well, congratulations, Jeff. We look forward to seeing what Sharecare does here now as a publicly traded company. Can't wait to hear about the new things you'll be acquiring and all the moves you're going to make over there to scale up those different layers of the cake. I love it. I absolutely love it. Congratulations again.
Okay. Thanks so much for having me and take care.
All right. Well, Sharecare starts trading tomorrow, July 2nd. So be sure to go check that out over there on the NASDAQ under the ticker symbol SHCR. Jeff Arnold, the CEO, co-founder, and chairman, thank you again for being with us. It's a pleasure to talk to you. Now you need to hit one of those celebrity cruises that is Sharecare verified so you can get out of here for a little bit and relax. Congrats again.
All right. Thank you. Take care.
Take care. Take care. I'm Jessica DeMassa with What's the Future Health. For more with the who's who of health tech and healthcare innovation, please check out my YouTube channel at youtube.com/WTF Health. We'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.